Hello, I'm Eric Bammon, and I'm standing in my kitchen today because it seemed completely appropriate for the topic of this video. If there's one person in the history of psychology who deserves much greater recognition than she has, it's Lillian Gilbreth, a remarkable woman whose impact on the fields of industrial psychology and engineering is still felt today. Gilbreth was a pioneering figure in the early 20th century, breaking through barriers as a woman in a male-dominated field and making important contributions to the world of work and efficiency. She was not only an accomplished psychologist, but she was a mother of 12 children, and her experiences in both arenas helped shape her unique perspective and approach to problem solving. In this video, we'll explore the life and legacy of Lillian Gilbreth, and I'll even show you at the end how she played a significant role in how a popular Steve Martin movie came to be. Gilbreth was born in 1878 in Oakland, California. Lillian was the eldest of nine surviving children and was educated at home until she was 9 years old. She then attended a public elementary school and was rapidly promoted through the grade levels. Lillian graduated from Oakland High School with exemplary grades in May 1896 and was elected vice president of her senior class. Her father was initially opposed to her attending college, but Lillian persuaded him to allow her to try the University of California for a year. She was admitted on the condition that she take a missing Latin course in her first semester. Lillian majored in English and studied philosophy and psychology. She also won a prize for poetry and acted in student plays. In her senior year, she was asked to be one of the student speakers at the commencement ceremonies and became the first woman to speak at a University of California commencement. Lillian began studying for a Ph.D. in psychology and education at the University of California, but took time off to travel in Europe, where she met her future husband, Frank Gilbreth. They married in 1904 and relocated to the East Coast, where Lillian studied with Thorndike at Columbia University and finished her dissertation in 1911. But the University of California would not award her PhD because she had lived outside the state too long. She did, however, publish her dissertation in a book titled The Psychology of Management, The Function of the Mind in Determining Teaching and Installing Methods of Least Waste. In 1914, Lillian enrolled at Brown University and earned a PhD in applied psychology. Her dissertation focused on the application of psychology and scientific management to the work of classroom teachers. Lillian became a pioneer in what is now known as industrial and organizational psychology, combining psychology with the study of scientific management and engineering. She and her husband were equal partners in their engineering and management consulting firm of Gilbert Incorporated. The Gilberts were especially adept at performing time and motion studies using the slogan, "The One Best Way to Do Work," to promote their methodology. They also developed a new technique for their studies that used a motion picture camera to reward work processes. The Gilberts' research on fatigue was a forerunner to the field of ergonomics. Their consulting business included implementing novel ideas at the time, such as an employee suggestion box, having rest periods at work, and redesigning jobs based on employee perspectives. They also developed ways to employ physically handicapped workers so they could become productive community members. Despite her successful career, Lillian was a devoted mother of 12 children. One of her children died young in 1912, but 11 of them lived to adulthood. Sadly, her husband Frank died in 1924, leaving Lillian to parent her children and continue their business on her own.
Later, after she had moved to Purdue University to become a professor, she worked with the legendary aviator Amelia Earhart. Lillian was interested in aviation and worked with Amelia to design airplane cockpits and equipment that would improve the safety and comfort of pilots during long flights. Lillian's contributions to aviation included the development of a system that allowed pilots to use their feet to control the airplane's rudder, which was previously controlled by hand. This innovation made flying safer and more comfortable for pilots, as they no longer needed to use their hands to control the rudder, which could become fatigued during long flights. In addition to her work in aviation, Lillian made significant contributions to motion study, human factors engineering, and psychology. Her work on motion analysis revolutionized the workplace, and her inventions increased productivity and efficiency. Take, for example, the kitchen. Lillian Gilbreth made several contributions to the modern kitchen, including the following. First, she worked on the development of several kitchen appliances that made household tasks easier and faster. She is credited with inventing the foot pedal trash can, the electric food mixer, and the shelves on the insides of refrigerator doors. Second, she applied her expertise in time and motion studies to the kitchen, analyzing how tasks were performed and developing more efficient methods. She's credited with popularizing the work triangle concept, which involves placing the stove, sink, and refrigerator in a triangular arrangement to maximize efficiency. Third, she was one of the pioneers of ergonomic design, which involves designing products and spaces that are comfortable, efficient, and safe to use. She applied this concept to the kitchen, developing countertops and workspaces at heights that were comfortable for the average woman. And fourth, Gilbreth worked on the design of the modern kitchen, which includes features like built-in cabinets and countertops, ample storage space, and a convenient layout. She advocated for the use of color and lighting in the kitchen to create a pleasant and inviting space. Gilbreth was also a champion of women in STEM and worked to promote their participation in these fields. She co-founded the Society of Women Engineers in 1950 and served as its first president. Through her work and advocacy, she inspired countless women to pursue careers in science and engineering. After she retired from Purdue, she continued to travel and deliver lectures. At the age of 86, she became the resident lecturer at the Massachusetts Institute of Technology. In 1968, when her health finally began to fail, she retired from her active public life and eventually entered a nursing home. She died in 1972 at the age of 94. Lillian is one of the few psychologists who was commemorated on a postage stamp in the United States. But she became famous in another way, which was that her two adult children ended up writing a book about their family and how their mother had taken care of them with all of these kids in the family, and titled it Cheaper by the Dozen. Cheaper by the Dozen was then made into a movie in 1950, and then it was remade again in 2003. However, if you watch the 2003 version and its sequel, there's very little resemblance to anything having to do with the Gilbreths. The children also wrote a sequel to the book called Bells on Their Toes, which was published in 1950. So why should you know about Lillian Gilbreth? Well, Lillian's innovations and contributions to a wide range of fields have had a lasting impact on the way we live and work today. From the paper feeding device to the adjustable oven rack to her work in human factors engineering and psychology, Lillian's inventions and research have made our lives easier and more efficient. Her work in aviation also improved safety and comfort for pilots, which was critical during a time when aviation was still a new and evolving field. Furthermore, Lillian's perseverance in the face of personal challenges and gender discrimination is truly inspiring. She continued to work and make significant contributions despite the death of her husband and raising 11 children as a single mother. Her advocacy for women in STEM also paved the way for future generations of women to pursue careers in these fields. In conclusion, Lillian Gilbreth was a remarkable figure whose work and advocacy continue to inspire us today. By learning about her life and contributions, we can gain a deeper appreciation for the advancements she made and the challenges she overcame, and we can be motivated to make our own contributions to society.
Well, I hope you enjoyed learning about this amazing person and now know why I'm standing in my kitchen. If you like this video, I hope you'll consider subscribing to this channel, where I have many more videos about psychology, famous people in psychology, and academia in general. And if you have an idea about a person or a topic that I should cover in the future, please let me know in the comments below. I hope to hear from you, and thanks for watching.